Generally, these ananasi fruits include custard apple or the sitapal common name, which is the ananas commosa. The other fruit is called bullock's heart or ramphal, which is botanically anana reticulata. Third fruit is cherry moyer or Lakshman pal, which is scientifically called anana cherimola. And the last one is the soursop, which is anana muricata. Among these fruits, only sitapal is available on large area, hence is of commercial importance. This custard apple is also known as sugar apple and is introduced to India from tropical America. It is also found in wild form in many parts of India. It is cultivated in Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Bihar, Orissa, Assam and Tamil Nadu. It is a very hardy, medium in growth and deciduous in nature. Fruits are generally used as table fruit, while some products like fruit pulp are used in various recipes. Besides high nutritional value, it has also a high medicinal value. Oven dried kernels of seeds contain about 30% of oil, which is used for making soaps and cake, and the cake is used as a manure. Due to the presence of anonin, the leaf stem and other parts of the plants are bitter in taste. Because of this bitterness in taste, goats or cattle do not eat these leaves. The leaves of custard apple yield a tetrahydroisoquinoline alkaloid, which is a cardiotonic active principle. It is identified as hygramine. Traces of hydrocyanic acid, that is HCN, is also reported in leaves, bark, root and seeds. Leaves also yield a blue or black dye. Different parts of the plants are widely used in folk medicine because of the bioactive compounds, mainly acetogenin, alkaloids, flavonoids found in the leaves, roots, fruits and seeds. Acetogenins are potential anti-cancer property compounds as they have cytotoxic effect. Flavonoids found in seeds, roots, bark, stems are potential chemopreventive agents, given evidence that they decrease tumor incidence. Ethanol extracts of cherry moya seeds are used as insecticides and the parasitic properties. The roots are used to treat acute dysentery, depression and spinal marrow diseases. The seeds are so hot that they may be swallowed whole with no ill effects, but the kernels are very toxic. Custard apple wood is yellow, rather soft, fibrous but durable, moderately close grained with a specific gravity of 0.65. It has been used to make yokes for oxen. Now we will see the climate and soil requirement of custard apple. Custard apple requires hot, dry climate during flowering and high humidity at fruit setting. Flowering comes during hot, dry climate of May, but fruit setting takes place on set of monsoon. Low humidity is harmful for pollination and fertilization. Custard apple withstands drought conditions, cloudy weather and also when temperature go below 15 degree C. Annual rainfall of 50 to 80 centimeter is optimum, though it can withstand higher rainfall. Custard apple can thrive well to an elevation of 1000 meters above mean sea level. The custard apple is not very particular about its soil requirement, and it can flourish well in all types of soil like shallow, sandy, but fails to grow if the subsoil is ill-dried. It can grow well in deep black soils provided they are well-dried. A little salinity or acidity does not affect it, but alkalinity, chloride, poor drainage or marshy wetlands hamper the growth and fruit setting. With rich in organic matter with a pH of 6 to 6.5 are ideal for custard apple. Now we will see the different varieties in custard apple. Custard apple is a seed propagated crop. Seedlings are found growing wild in India. Since it is a cross-pollinated crop, wide variation in form, size, color of the pulp, seed number, quality and yield is observed. This natural variability is utilized to identify superior genotypes, which are usually named after the place of collection, like Baranagar, Purandar, etc. Color of the fruits like red custard apple and size of areoles like mammoth. Some of the important varieties we will see now. One is Baranagar. It is a popular variety of Andhra Pradesh, grows to a height of 3.5 to 4 meter. The yield potential of this variety is very high, with a fruit size of 350 to 450 gram with lesser number of seeds, say 40 to 80. Pulp is white, buttery sweet, with a TSS of 29%, acidity 0.24%. Next variety is Mammoth, which is a high yielding variety with a prolific bearer. Fruits are irregular in shape. The average fruit weight is about 180 to 200 gram. The areoles are medium to big in size, very smooth and round. The mesocarp is white in color, small to medium segment. The number of seeds is less, 15 to 30 seeds per fruit. And the fruit has a good keeping quality. Next variety is red sitapal. The fruits are medium in size, 170 to 250 gram. The rind is pink, slightly acidic, sweet, TSS 25% with good quality fruits, acidity about 0.21% with small size seeds. Next variety is Barbados. The fruits are of small to medium in size, 170 to 200 gram. Fruits are spherical in shape. The mesocarp with medium size areoles with creamy white pulp, moderately sweet, with TSS of 24% as acidity of 0.21%. This is a high yielding variety. Then British Guinea. This is also a high yielding variety. Fruits remain green at ripening, medium in size, say 170 to 340 gram. Mesocarp is white, soft, pulp is white, moderately juicy, with a sweet taste, about 25% TSS. Islander, it's a large fruit, nearly 410 gram, TSS 26% with less seeded. The Atimoya, which is a hybrid between Anana scomosa and Anana cherimoya, has sweet pulp with fewer seeds. Next is Arka Sagan. This is a progeny of island gem, a hybrid between Anana Atimoya and Anana scomosa. Fruits come to harvest in September, October, and mature fruits, say 210 gram, take about 6 to 7 days to ripe. The skin has a waxy bloom, light green in color, moderately thick with large flat eyes. The creamy white color flesh is juicy with mild pleasant aroma and tender with scarce seeds, say 9 seeds per 100 gram of the pulp and large segments. The edible pulp is remarkable for its sweetness with a TSS of 30%. Propagation methods of Anana. Both sexual and asexual methods are employed for propagating the Anana plants. However, to maintain the genetic uniformity for obtaining higher yield of better quality fruits, clonal multiplication is recommended. Different methods of vegetative propagation followed are cuttings, grafting and budding. In the case of cutting, 90% success is reported when cuttings are etiolated 15 days before planting and treated with NAA 5000 ppm and rooted under intermittent mist condition. Rooting success is only 2 to 5%. Budding, here it can be successfully budded using shield, patch, modified forget and chip butting method, among which shield butting is most successful. Sitapal on its own rootstock or on cherry moyer has given 60 to 80% success. Budding is done in early spring when the sap starts flowing. For taking the bud, dormant previous year shoots are preferred. The seedling rootstocks, however, exhibit wide variability in growth and yield of the scion. Next is grafting method. It can be propagated successfully by grafting. Among the different grafting methods like trunk, cleft, veneer, inarching, splice, inarching grafting is most successful, especially using Annona cherimola and Annona reticulata as scions. The seedlings of local custard apple have proved a good rootstock material. Seeds of cherimoya treated with 10,000 ppm of GA3 significantly increases the percentage of germination, say even up to 70%. Now we will see planting and cropping system for custard apple. The fruits come in market from semi-wild forest in Deccan Plateau. A very few commercial plantations of custard apple are available in India. For cultivation, about 6 months to 1 year old seedlings and grafts are considered quite suitable for transplanting when they are not raised in situ. The pits of 45 to 60 centimeter cube are dug on deep soil. Pits are filled with a mixture of topsoil, farmyard manure, 15 to 20 kg, 300 grams of fertilizer mixtures containing urea, superphosphate and muriate of potash in equal proportion is recommended. The distance of planting on poor soil is 4 meter and on good soil anything from 5 to 7 meter both away in square system of planting. Closer planting is recommended in rain-fed regions with a view to improve pollination by maintaining more humidity. The best time of planting for custard apple is the beginning of rainy season to avail the advantage of rainwater. Aftercare. Care of young orchard is very important. Here, gap filling is to be done as early as possible. Stagnation of water during first monsoon should be avoided. In respect of training and pruning, the newly planted custard apples are supported with wooden props fixed near the stem. It will help to grow the plant straight. The plants are trained to single stem up to 1 meter height. The custard apple is very slow growing plant. It forms small bush with large number of branches of various sizes and ages. The fruits are borne on new as well as on old wood. Light pruning of the old wood induces better branching of the plant. The custard apple normally goes to dormancy from November to December. The plants remain in leafless condition for about 2 months in winter months and new growth emerges with the onset of spring. Pruning should be carried out when the plant starts new growth in early spring after dormancy. Water, nutrient and weed management practices for custard apple. In general, custard apple is grown as a rain-fed crop and no irrigation is given. However, for early and bumper harvest of the crop, irrigation, especially during flowering, that is from May, should be given till regular monsoon starts. Manuring and fertilization. Custard apple is mostly cultivated on poor soils, thus manures and fertilizers should be applied for better growth and yield. For bearing plants, 50 kg of farmyard manure, 1 kg of castor cake and 1 kg of bone meal are to be applied during June-July. 250 gram of nitrogen, 125 gram of single superphosphate and 125 gram of potash per plant per year should be applied in 2 splits when there is moisture in the basin, that is during June-July and again during August-September. The fertilizer dose for young plants is recommended at the rate of 250 gram of nitrogen, 125 gram of P2O5 and 125 gram of potash. Now we will see the plant growth regulation in this crop. Custard apple has a short juvenile period. The plants begin flowering within 4 years of planting. Anana species bears flowers on old and current season growth. The flowering period of custard apple is very long, commencing from March, April and continues up to July, August. Peak flowering is observed in April and May. For initiation, a floral bud develops into flower in 27 to 35 days depending on the species. No fruit set occurs during the entire spring and summer, and it commences only during rainy season, leaving little period for the late set fruits to develop before the onset of winter months. The setting of fruits early in the season is important because immature fruits, instead of developing inedible in winter season, turn into stone fruits. During fruit development, 50 ppm of GA, 5 ppm and 0.5 ppm of CPPU foliar spray improves the fruit size and luster of the fruits. Pollination is a very important in custard apple as it affects the yield and quality of the custard apple. Custard apple has complete flowers, that is a bisexual. However, the male and female flower parts are functional at different times of the day. This condition is called protandry, wherein an organism begins life as a male or female and changes the sex later. Custard apple flowers first open during the day as a female flower. If the female flower is not pollinated, early in the next morning, the flowers open wide and shed pollen. Say that is the male stage. It is recommended to attract pollinating insects or hand pollinate the flowers for best yield. Now we will see what are the factors which affect the fruit set. A custard apple tree may bear about 1500 to 2000 flowers, but hardly 2 to 3% of the flowers only set and develop into fruit. This low fruit set is due to dichogamy, high temperature and low humidity at the time of flowering and lack of pollinating agents. The setting of fruit early in the season is important, but in India, the early flowers produce no pollen, hence artificial pollination is difficult. It is possible to increase the set of the fruits during the rainy season. By hand pollination of flowers, 85% of set can be obtained compared with 30% in natural pollinated ones. Another factor which affects the fruit set is dichogamy. Some custard apple trees shed pollen in the morning, others in the afternoon. The stigma are not receptive when the pollen is shed, and the receptivity also remain for a short period. Hence, it is cross-pollinated. Pollen grains are sticky. The wind pollination is very less effective. There are no insect pollinators for custard apple. So, to increase the fruit set, application of NAA at 20 ppm during flowering for 3 to 4 times at 8 to 10 days interval is recommended, besides spraying with GA3 at 50 ppm. Some of the important disorders affecting custard apples are stone fruits. Custard apple plants go to dormancy immediately after the harvest of the fruit. In the neglected trees, the dormancy starts very early. On such trees, the fruits prematurely turn brown. Such fruits are known as stone fruits. These fruits continue to stay on the tree even after new growth commenced in spring. The occurrence of such fruit is common during November-December season. The formation of stone fruit may be due to physiological disorder or malnutrition. Application of superphosphate or bone meal improves the crop yield and reduces formation of stone fruits. When the trees are cultivated and attended properly, the fruits reach at harvest earlier than the dormancy period, thus escape development of the stone fruits. Pest attacking custard apples are, one is the mealybug. It is Planococcus pacifragus. They affect the new growth of the custard apple during spring season. Besides aphids and jacids also attack this. These pests are effectively controlled with a spray of monocotophos at 0.2% or Rogar at 0.1% concentration. In respect of the diseases, leaf spot is very important. The symptoms are water soaked lesions, mostly angular in shape, which is developing on the leaves. The lesions are dark brown to grayish and vary in size. Single leaf may have over than 100 lesions. The lesions dry off and wither, resulting in a scorched appearance of the affected leaves. The fruits may also be infected in severe cases. Next is the Cercospora annonae, which is a fungal pathogen. This pathogen perpetuates only through the conidial stage. The pathogen survives in host tissues all the year around, and thus inoculum is also available for new infection. To control this, fungicidal spray is recommended. Another leaf spot which is caused by Pleosporoides annonae is also reported in this crop. Root rot disease caused by Diplodia netalensis is also another important disease. This pathogen is soil habitant, attacking the roots and spreading upwards to the basal portion of the stem, causing wilting of plants. When the disease appears in one or two plants in the plantation, the area of such tree must be isolated, plants should be cut and destroyed. Other plants can be replaced with a protective cover on the trunk with the Bodo paste, also drenching the soil around the stem with Bodo mixture. Fruit rot is another disease. Here the pathogen attacks the younger leaves, stem, inflorescence and fruits. The affected fruits develop black spots and the skin becomes discolored. The fruit pulp below the spots become hard and decay at ripening. The affected fruits may drop off prematurely. Severely spotted fruits have low market value. The disease spreads rapidly during rainy season. It is caused by Glomerulla cingulata. It can be managed by avoiding overcrowding of planting and giving a preventive spray with Bodo mixture. Dipping the mature fruits in hot water at 51 degrees C for 15 minutes saves from damage during storage. Next is the pink disease caused by Pellicloria salmonicolor. Here, powdery coating on the stem can be seen as an initial symptom. Later, girdling of the stem happens. Pink color is due to the conidia which produce on the stem surface. Affected shoots show wilting, shedding of leaves, finally the branches dry out. In some cases, the fungus may produce pustules which are of orange-red color and are arranged on rows along the stem. The pathogen persists from season to season through dormant mycelium inside the bark and cancerous tissues. The disease may be checked by cutting and removing the affected branches. Cut wounds must be protected with fungicidal paste. Anthracnose, the fungus is the Glomerulla cingulata. It infects on the fruits, which starts from blossom end and later spreads on the entire fruit surface. Affected fruits may fall down from the tree. Maturity indices and harvest. Custard apple is an aggregate fruit. The custard apple is a climacteric fruit again, and harvesting must be done at proper maturity state when the fruit starts to change its color from green to its varietal color shade. Immature fruits do not ripe. The interareolar space widens, the fruits turn creamy white, skin between the segments or tubercles turn into light yellow color. Another indication of ripening is the change in the color of the seeds, which pass from light brown color to almost black at the ripening stage. Now we will see the harvesting technique. If the fruits are left on the plant unduly long, they split up and get damaged. Custard apple fruits are climacteric, so they have to be harvested when they are mature, firm and plumpy. Fruits are harvested when the segments become conspicuous and the color between the segments changes from white to light yellow or orange. Fruits also change color from green to light green. The skin between the segments turns into light yellow color when the fruits have fully matured. It ripens within a week after fruits are harvested. If the fruits are harvested before maturity, the segments held together and the fruits become hard, the pulp ferments and the quality becomes poor. Custard apple ripens during October-December in dry region, whereas in humid areas, harvesting is done during August. For transporting over distant markets, the fruits are picked before fully ripening and are packed in single layer, well-ventilated wooden boxes with soft cushioning materials. The fruits must be harvested by cutting the stem using a pruning shears. Also, it should be harvested in the morning hours. Sugar apple fruit is very delicate and should be harvested with extra care. In respect of the yield, the seedling plants start fruiting within 4 to 5 years, while the grafted or budded plants give their fruits in 3 to 4 years. After 15 years, reduction in fruiting has been reported in many plantations. The period of fruit development from flowering to harvesting covers about 4 months. A good bearing tree of custard apple will give around 100 to 150 fruits. Each fruit weighs about 80 to 120 gram and contains about 30 to 60 seeds. Well-managed crop produces about 8 to 10 tonnes of fruits per hectare depending on the varieties grown. Now we will see the post-harvest management. Ananas fruits can be stored in good conditions up to 7 days by treating them with 8% wax emulsions. They do not respond well to cold storage. They should not be frozen or refrigerated below 8 degrees C. Keeping the fruits longer than 5 days at this temperature will cause chilling injuries as evident by a brown aged appearance. While summing up the production technology of custard apple, we have seen custard apple is introduced to India from tropical America. It is also found wild in form of many parts of India, cultivated in states like Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Bihar, Orissa, Assam and Tamil Nadu. Fruits are generally used as a table fruit, while some products like fruit pulp are used in various recipes. Besides high nutritive value, it has a high medicinal value also. It can be grown in all types of soil, right from shallow, sandy, but fails to grow if the subsoil is ill-drained. A little salinity or acidity does not affect it. Soils which are rich in organic matter with a pH of 6 to 6.5 are highly ideal. Custard apple requires hot, dry climate during flowering and high humidity at fruiting stage. Flowering comes during hot, dry climate of May, but fruit setting takes place on the onset of monsoon. Custard apple is a seed propagated crop and seedlings are found growing wild in India. Some of the varieties grown commercially in different agroclimatic regions are Balahanor, Mammoth, Red Sitapal, Barbados, British Guinea, Islander, Atimoya and Arkasagan. Both sexual and asexual methods are employed for propagating ananas plants. However, to maintain the genetic uniformity, clonal propagation is recommended through cuttings, grafting or budding. The main problem affecting the yield and fruit quality of custard apple tree is pollination of flowers. Custard apple has bisexual flowers. However, male and female flower parts are functional at different times of the day. Important pests and diseases are mealybug, leaf spot, root rot, fruit rot, pink diseases and anthracnose. The custard apple seedlings start fruiting in 3 to 5 years and is a climatic fruit, hence must be harvested at matured states. When the fruit starts to change its color from green to its varietal color shade. Good bearing tree gives about 100 to 150 fruits. Each fruit weighs about 80 to 120 gram. Well managed crop produces about 8 to 10 tons of fruits per hectare. Anana fruits can be stored in good conditions up to 7 days. They do not respond well to cold storage, but they should not be frozen or refrigerated below 8 degrees C.